Aside from emotional interference and ADHD, brain-based factors can also cause our processing speed to slow down. But how? Let's find out by asking these three questions. What parts of the brain are implicated in slow processing speed? Why are some people born with slow processing speed? And how is information passed from neuron to neuron in the brain? Let's find out. 1. What parts of the brain are implicated in slow processing speed? The science of slow processing speed is complicated. Motivation and interest can have some impact on processing speed, but at the root of it is biology. While the cause of slow processing speed can vary, recent discoveries in neuroscience suggest that a lot of brain-based factors contribute to slow processing speed. The parts of the brain which are implicated in slow processing speed include the frontal lobe, which is the place in the brain where many executive functioning skills are focused. There is some evidence that decreased volume in the frontal lobe is related to speed of processing. The composition of the neurons in the brain has also been associated with slow processing speed. There's this fatty substance called myelin. And myelin does two things. Myelin insulates the signals which the brain sends between neurons, and myelin improves the efficiency of the signals which the brain sends between neurons. And there's evidence that myelin may have an impact on processing speed. This theory suggests that lower amounts of myelin surrounding your neurons may slow down your processing speed. 2. Why are some people born with slow processing speed? Slow processing speed might be caused by someone's brain structure, specifically someone's dendrite length. What are dendrites? Let me tell ya, dendrites are a specialized part of a neuron. Brain cells or neurons look very different than other cells, which tend to be very small and circular in shape. Brain cells are long and wiry and shaped a bit like trees. The trunk or axon is the longest part of the neuron, and dendrites would be the branches which extend from the tree. In order for information to pass from neuron to neuron, chemicals called neurotransmitters essentially need to jump across a space between one dendrite to another, and we call this space a synapse. In some cases, a person may have fewer dendrites, or the dendrites might be too short. In either case, the space between the neurons is greater, which means that the neurotransmitters have a farther distance to jump. As a result, information takes longer to be passed on. Another reason for slow processing speed might be that someone has fewer neurotransmitters. For example, a lack of production of the neurotransmitter serotonin can cause depression. And one prevalent symptom of depression is slower processing speed. If you have fewer neurotransmitters related to processing speed, or if your neurotransmitters run into problems passing on information, which we call synaptic delay, that could potentially cause slow information processing. Some causes of synaptic delay include genetic factors, drug use, or exposure to toxic chemicals or heavy metals. 3. How is information passed from neuron to neuron in the brain? Let's consider a neurotransmitter's route when passing information. When our brains pass information from neuron to neuron, the information takes a specific route called a neural pathway. Over time, if we regularly access this same information, the information continues to take the same neural pathway in our brains. The more often we do or recall this information, the faster our brains pass on this information each time we access it. Think about how many times you need to hear a song before you have memorized the lyrics by heart. Most of what makes our brains human has to do with activity in the frontal lobe, especially in an area called the prefrontal cortex. As I said earlier in this video, this is where most of our executive functioning and thus information processing takes place. This is where we do our human thinking, things like planning, reasoning, regulating emotions, and interpreting visual data. If someone has a poorly organized frontal lobe, though, this may be yet another factor that slows down information processing. This might simply be due to malformations, or it can be the result of brain or head injuries. For those of us who aren't neuroscientists, it's probably most important to recognize the biological factors at the root of slow processing speed. Rather than blaming a person for being slow, we should understand that their brains might be struggling to process information efficiently. This doesn't mean we can't help them get a little bit faster and to be more focused. The neuroscience of slow processing speed suggests that we look for alternative ways for them to reach their potential and to reduce the frustration they experience due to slow processing speed. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video. If you found this video interesting, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. In 6 weeks, I'll be back with a new video in this series on intellectual giftedness. Till then, I only want to say 4 things. Thank you for watching. Have a great summer. Take care, and bye for now.